Here in Boletaria, we speak of the legend of the two swords and the last hero. The two swords are Demonbrand and Soulbrand. One sword banishes that which befouls man, and the other banishes man himself. The last hero is Old King Doran. King Doran is the Everlasting One, founder of Boletaria and protector of the two swords. Of course, only according to legend. But in the dark state of our land, legends are all we can depend upon.
Yes, yeah, so that's the, like I said, you get the demon, you get the Soulbrand. No, you get Demonbrand. Before the end of the game, you get Soulbrand as like the final boss. You beat it. So then only in New Game Plus can you combine. So I guess that's pretty much exclusive content for New Game Plus, is you cannot get the combined sword, the Northern Regalia, as it's called, until New Game Plus. But I can't combine them yet because I haven't met the blacksmith, the other blacksmith. Not this one. He can't do it. He's not as experienced.
King Alant led Boletaria with a round table of brave knights. The royal twin Fangs, Valifax and Bure. Alfred, the knight of the tower. Metas, the knight of the lance. And the brave tribesman, Longbow Ulan, and his fearsome legions. But today, Boletaria is an abysmal mess. Valifax was lost. And Bure slipped through the fissure, never to be heard from again. All the rest, along with Boletaria, have been devoured by the fog, and will soon be prey to the demons. The Boletarian knights are no longer. But perhaps our age will see the rise of new heroes, such as yourself.
So yeah, interesting. I've seen with the remake, some of them is actually confirmed that those knights he's talking about are actually some of the bosses that get turned into. I don't know if they got turned into demons or it's just like their essence, but they're representations of them at least.
Thou seekest soul power, dost thou not? Then touch the demon and.
It's an interesting, like I said, you know, the games are fun to play, but there's also interesting lore that I love to delve into. Most of the demon bosses are actually like, it's interesting kind of. All the demon bosses are kind of like legends of the land that are kind of made manifest in a weird way. Like, there would probably be demons without that, but I don't know if they just like, if they build themselves up from the legends. You'll see later that there's like, there's a shield. This definitely has the, it tells the story of this, like, is an ancient adjudicator god, and then the demon boss of that area is like that actual thing made manifest. So I'm not sure if it was a demon before, or if that means it's just like taking the local legends and like building itself off of that. We don't know, but it's interesting to think about. All right, I think I was just pumping vitality endurance, right? Wait, hold on, I have my stat sheet here. Let me grab it real quick. Let's see, I know luck. That's what I was saying, like, my damage is not going to get that much higher, because the only thing I have to pump is magic that'll increase damage, but that only increases magic with, like, it only increases damage with light weapon when I have the buff. It's not going to increase damage all the time. Let's see, I don't want to, you know, go past my points I need now, but I think, yeah, I have a lot more to do with endurance and vitality. I should probably do vitality, shouldn't I? Because that's what's. I mean, I already can manage stamina pretty well. Like, I'm a Souls veteran. It's nice to have more stamina, but I know how to manage stamina because I played all of the games except for Sekiro. It's the only one I haven't played yet, but it's on the list. I've beaten, you know, 2, 3 Bloodborne, this one, obviously. So I feel like vitality is most important here. But for this thing, it's going to be like a lot. It's like up to 50 vitality. I'm at 20. So maybe that's why I'm dying so much. Yeah, I should pump that as much as I can. Let's see. So, I wonder if I could do a bit more with the ones I have. Because you can just kind of pop more souls to get more things. Let's see. I take the highest. What was it? 30,000? Pretty sure, yeah. This could be enough pretty easily, I think. How much was it? Was it 30 something? 37. It's because we're so close to the other one, I don't want to lose extra souls or anything.
Soul of the mind, key to life's ether. Soul of the lost, withdrawn from its vessel.
Maybe that'll help me have a bit more, take a bit more hits. So I could do more, maybe I should, I don't know. Because I'm not really upgrading anything, right? It's only if I need to buy healing items, but I do have a lot. Maybe I should just, like, stay here and upgrade everything. 38. Let's see. It's one thing the remake definitely does, I think, is from what I've seen, it makes this a lot easier. Here you have to, like, go through and do each individual soul. And in the remake, and all the ones after it, you can kind of just choose, like, a large amount and just do them all at once. Instead of having to do each one individually. I think I'm going to upgrade, and then I'm going to go back. Because I don't really have to worry about... Oh, I can do it already. I don't really have to worry about, you know, making the world harder, because I'm already a pure black, so... I guess... Oh, that's right. Because I need to reload it. It does go down after you beat a boss, I forgot. But you have to reload. So once I... Even though I beat a boss last time, because I went and reloaded, it's already set to take me to the highest pure black... That's all I need to do, I think.
Soul of the mind, key to life's
I need to remember to do that.
Soul of the lost, withdrawn from its
that's probably enough for now. Let's see, what do I want on here? I need some sort of spice, yeah. I do have a lot of old spice, actually. So I use that up. What else could be good to have? You know, I like to have, like, something to do poison. And then whatever other buff I can use. Yeah, seems good. I need to reload, I think. Let's do that to... Both to save the game and to reload the world tendency system. Because I don't want to... Yeah, I want to do... Like, I'm doing a challenge run here, so I don't want to... screw myself out of something accidentally like that. Because I beat the boss last time and immediately, like, I leveled up and turned the game off, so... It's like when you load back in, then it resets the tendency to your chosen thing. That's normally how you would lower the tendency, is you beat a boss and then that pushes it towards white. Because you're, like, clearing the area, basically. You're clearing the area of corruption. So, that makes sense. So I think I'm going to go try that lady once more. I'll use my, you know, human form to go fight her. Did I put up everything? Let's see. Change that. I think so. Yeah.
We are...
Now, let me make sure that I'm... Yeah, so when you reload, it goes back to the full darkness, imprisoning me. All that I see, absolute horrors. That's weird that you can go there. That's a feature of New Game Plus. But luckily, this fight is pretty close to the... It's like, I'm not going to have more damage, but I'm going to have more health, so let's see. I guess I should probably just try to fight her. I was getting too fancy trying to, like, push her off the edge. I mean, you can do that, but it's risky. I don't know. Let's see. I do have my... Yeah, I have this on. So maybe by the time I get to her, it'll have recovered enough for me to use light weapon. Okay. Come on. Now, you can both do this. Not at the same time. And you need to come because you always follow me down there. Go. Let's go try to do this again. The hard way. I guess that lizard will come back, yeah. That's not good. Because I don't really need it, you know? Like, I'm not upgrading. Pretty much my build is set. It's just the shield that I need a special thing for. Everything else is pretty much done. So whatever. I don't really care about the lizard too much. Normally I would parry these guys' jumping attacks like that, but now I don't trust it. Okay, don't stay there. No, 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 no. I almost comboed to death there. Okay, I need to use more than that. Please don't. Okay, thank you. No, 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 no. All they give you is Crestman. I guess that's what they normally drop, but it seems like the Black Phantom. I want to say Red Phantom, because I don't know why they're called Black Phantom. They're very red. Like, parts of them are black, but it makes sense in the lore. I guess Black Phantom is, you know, it's like pure darkness. It should be more like Shadow Phantom. But is there a way to get? No, they all spawn at the same time, don't they? Oh, no, no, they don't actually have to. Like, is there a way to get just one to spawn? That would be nice. There we go. That's how you do it. A lot easier. Very cinematic. I was like, quit dropping me this Crescent Moon. I don't even need it anymore. Let's see if I can. Can I get just one more to spawn? Thank you. Do it the cheesy way. And try this one more time, and then if I die, then I'm just gonna keep doing this, I guess. Like, go beat a boss, and then come back. Try fighting this lady again. Just because she's optional. I know I'm gonna have to. There's a point where there's definitely one in the way that you have to fight. And that's gonna be the tricky one. You have. It's a wall, like, you have to get past it somehow. Two more. I think I can handle two. Broken sword. Okay, let's see. Let's see what can be done here. Come here. Come out. Oh my god. The damage. Like, you have to backstab or parry to do any damage. Good lord. Okay, that was nice. That's not what I was trying to do, man. If I can combo her into backstabs, that would be nice. Ooh, that was a different hit than I was expecting. Look at that, it went through my whole shit. My whole second chance. Can you stop for a second, please? No, no. How far does she follow you? Now I'm curious. To go back eventually. So I would like to have my thing back, please, before I fuck with you. If I could, please. Jesus, the damage. Wow, she just comes, right? I didn't know she followed you all the way back. I thought she would, like, tether eventually. Okay, now it looks like she's gone. Damn it. I want my second chance. Swing, 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 swing. Okay, I really don't feel comfortable with that. Okay. Forgot the NPCs did that when they get stuck and they just swing it, whatever. As long as I have this, I'm like, I'm fairly confident enough, I guess. Much as one can be. Doesn't seem like she heals, so that's good. Something. Okay. Barely got my shield up there in time. It's like a real PvP match here. Look at that damage. It's like chip damage, nothing. Give me that. I don't really want to cheese you, but Jesus. It's clear that you can kill me, so what are you doing? I don't want to win like that with no fight. Ooh. Does that do it? It was risky going for that last pair. Okay, Jesus. Very cool. This is a cool weapon. I've seen people use it before. I don't have the, yeah, don't have the stats. And I think it looks way worse actually in the remake. I've seen it. It's like, oh, that sucks that they changed it. It's pretty cool. It's just like a guillotine that it looked like she just ripped off from the gallows over there, where she hangs out and just kind of used it as a weapon, which is pretty interesting. It's just like a cool axe moveset. I thought about using this as my build, my weapon. But I went with the blue blood sword instead. Alright. So that's pretty cool. Let's see, was there anything? I know there's something in there, but I'm kind of worried that I'm going to fall and die. There's something I need in there, though. I don't know if I should go spin these souls yet or not. The issue is that it's easy to fall here. Where's the cat ring? Maybe I need that. Cat's mane. Gives you a little real cat image there in the top left. But it stops you from fall damage, which is nice, because what I need is like there. So I have to like fall off of this thing, which is the most stressful thing possible. Like, your second health bar does not help if you fall. It is not how it works. Yeah. You can't fall there. Yeah, but then you can't turn around. That's the issue. If you slide off at any point, like that. Yep, it's gone. Oh boy. I guess we'll try to do that before we finish. I don't care about the. I still have the killing arrow. Whoops. I didn't really need that on the whole time. Because I was in body form, I didn't need that. Forgot about that. I think I can get through here. I just can't take the red phantom guys too easily, but the lady will not respawn. She's a one-time she's a one-time enemy. As long as you kill her, she's gone for the playthrough. Because they're like an NPC. You know, the NPC, the evil version of an NPC, so. They have NPC rules where it's like, if you kill them, they're gone, so. That's why they're pretty special. For each level. Yeah, we could do this instead of all five at the same time. Now I know the strategy. To get them separated like this. All right. I do like that they have the same sound as like a player spawning in, invading. There we go. It's later than I expect. I'm so scared with the damage. I'm like, I need to do it fast. So yeah, she will not be in here anymore. She's gone. Like, they're very tough, but once you take them out once, they're gone. So, okay. But what's the best way to do this? It seems like this is the way you're supposed to go, because I don't know. They're at the same coordinates as the one above it, so there has to be a hole you can go through. Okay. Now, like the other guy, spinning around is the issue. So you can backstep. Kind of go here. That's what I want. No, it doesn't matter. Well, it doesn't matter if I die, because I want my souls, but... Where's the hole here? That's too far to fall, I think. Is there a hole for me to fall upon? I guess over there. Oh yeah, because that's not the same heights. They're not the same coordinates as this one. I don't know why you do this. Like, it's not meant for this. This game does not handle this too well. Please, okay. Okay. I'm not gonna pick this up because this is a super heavy thing that I already have from the last playthrough. So. Oh, and then... okay, yeah. I always forget about the ladder climbing until I... So this is as fast as you can go. As you can see, I'm hitting the button. I'm holding. The remake did change this, I believe. I believe you can... In every game after this, you can sprint up ladders, basically. You can, like, go faster. But this one, you just have to wait... Check out the bodies. This is clearly because there's a bunch of bodies down there. And the executioner lady was at the top, so this is like a dumping pit, basically. That's why there's like a soul down there that you need. Because this is a dumping pit, yeah. It's all themed, just environmental storytelling. And it's fine. Let's see, there's like a little slide here. She's here hanging out. And out here is the gallows, you know. They hang people or guillotine them. And then she just hangs out in here and she puts the bodies down there. She was already mad, presumably before even the demons showed up. Here's the thing where clearly there was a guillotine. So that's a whole little section. This is quite a tough little area. But you see why I avoided it the first time. I'm glad we can do that. I don't even know if I can upgrade my thing until I reach the other blacksmith. Probably not. But I do have the soul now, so. That's the only thing I'm looking forward to upgrading. Do I have enough to level up? Jeez, barely, yeah, okay. Okay.
As for me, I am only here to tend to the flames. I keep the candles lit and serve the brave demon slayers who are trapped here. Art thou done, may thou?
Very good. Have anything? Hello, I'm keeping I have things to deposit. At least this. I appreciate it, but it's not for my build now. That's what I need to upgrade, but I don't know if I can. I can try. No, he can't do it. There's very little he can actually do. It's very basic things.
Do come back alive.
A miracle is a heavenly act, but spells are the acts of demons, the work of soul arts. They have similar effects, and yet one is clearly evil, and the other is clearly good. Magicians, in the end, are mere servants of the demons. A miracle, they magic. I see. I pray we.
But that's an interesting thing you learn from the lore is like, go look at this. Talisman of Beasts allows me to do miracles and magic together, like with the same thing, which is supposed to be different. An old wooden amulet resembling the old one. Yeah, the. You'll see the final boss. I can utilize both miracles and spells. The symbol of God was nothing more than the image of the old one. So it seems to be hinting at that they think this is different. The miracles are God and magic is from the old one, like the demon, the devil. But it turns out, I think they're pretty much the same thing. They just believe that it's not.
Me, without doubt, I made my best effort to save Sage Freak. But I had not the strength. It's as simple as that. Besides, if I myself were captured, who would stand here and recruit rescuers?
I don't remember getting this dialogue before. It's pretty funny.
Besides, if I myself...
Yeah. They're all like...
I see. So just ensure that you...
He's the same as the other guy. He's like... Oh, Saint Urbane, you know, I left him. I want to be punished, but I have not the strength to punish myself. Like, shut up. If you wanted to be punished, you would be punished. You'd be punishing yourself. And this guy over here is like, oh, I would go rescue him, but I would recruit other people to rescue him if I went. And I was like, shut up. They're both the same. What is this? These are people doing weird things. Alrighty, let's, that's enough for today. Seems like a good session. Go back over here. I will see you next time. This is like the second session, I guess, but I'm just going to be going through it. So I'll see you next time. Hope you have a good day and have a happy 2021. It's almost that time. It's like the end of 2020. So let's see. Hope it's a good year. Let's do it.